Of the 1 million angioplasty cases in the U.S., up to 10% are considered high risk. But a new device is improving treatment for those patients. Liz Bruner shows us how one hospital is using the world's smallest heart pump. It's new tonight.
Just being able to water the flowers is a blessing for Kim Zioli. She survived two heart attacks in 1991, battled other health problems, only to learn recently that her heart was failing.
They found out I had congestive heart failure.
Blocked arteries in her legs put her at high risk for heart failure during surgery. But this cutting-edge device, made by Danvers-based Abiomed, helped increase her odds of getting through a high-risk angioplasty procedure.
So it supports the ventricle in high-risk cardiac cases.
Dr. Faisal Khan works at St. Elizabeth's Medical Center, the first Boston hospital to use the FDA-improved Impella. There have been two patients so far. Kim was the first. The device is inserted into the groin, and it goes into the blood vessel in the heart and sits within the left ventricle.
He's able to suck blood out of the ventricle and push it back into the rest of the heart. So it's doing what the left ventricle would be doing, and in a very sick patient whose heart is not doing what it's supposed to, this then takes over that role.
Therefore, the heart uses less energy and less oxygen, and the patient's outcome improves dramatically.
I have been living on 35% of my heart, you know, and it's been awful. I can't do anything anymore. But now I feel like it's starting to come back and I'm going to be all right.
And that is good news. Now, the Impella was approved by the FDA back in June.